Hi, this is Gemini Dhar. I'm a take charge expert and author, and I've been sharing some amazing, lovely stories of women who have impacted thousands and thousands of lives. So I have Dr. Sagareeka Bhatia with me, and I specifically got her onto this channel because she is an educator, a principal of a school. She looks great. No, she's an amazing human being, and she's got some lovely strategies from the experience with children that she has and with parents. So Sagareeka, before I introduce you in detail, I just wanted to share one thing, that there was a family where the child is very, very high performing, one child, and the other child is very simple. So the parents are putting all the focus into building the career for this particular child, and the other child is happy, being taken care of, but somewhere the child is taking a back seat. I have seen this in my family itself. My daughter, very, very close to me, and you know, I'm into women empowerment, I understand. So I consciously took up the time to nurture my son, bring him up, because I'm very powerful and I really believe in women empowerment. In that process, somewhere we forget the other person who is soft spoken, who is not very outspoken, and there is an imbalance in parenting a lot of times. So Sagareeka, when I did your YouTube live today, and sorry, the Facebook live, and you shared about the H, you know, and the way you explained was so effortless. I think a lot of parents will take you seriously and understand. So if you are a parent, if you are a son, if you are a daughter, if you are a mother, or anybody who is in touch with children or humans, you should look at this interview and share this, because Sagareeka is going to share something amazing. Before that, Sagareeka, I want you to explain your journey in short, how you were as a child, what inspired you to become who you are today.
Right. Well, as a child, I was a very naughty child, and thereafter, I mean, I think somewhere I was so naughty and I wanted to do so many things that it was difficult for my parents to control, and also I wanted to expose myself to many things, and then my parents thought it right that they should put me in a boarding school where I can use 24 hours to do whatever I want to do. And I was very fortunate to be in a boarding school at Panchgani, wherein it was a very small, nice school.
It was like a luxury vacation.
Yes, absolutely, over there. And then, do you know, in the evening you want to sing a song, you want to dance, you go play sports. So that really catered to my overall development, and actually today whatever I am is thanks to my parents, and thanks for their insight and their vision of putting me in a boarding school and me grooming myself this way.
Super.
You know? So that was really wonderful. And my parents stayed in Africa. I was born in Sri Lanka, and then I was staying in Bombay. I studied in Panchgani in Maharashtra. So all these things together made me a global citizen.
So like you were talking, yes, you've been to each, you know, you've been like
absolutely
every corner of
this
world.
Yes. And that being a global citizen, I think I can touch people's heart. And that's what motivated me to take up teaching as a profession.
Super.
Yeah. And for the parents also, as I told you about the three H's, you know. So the three H's go very well with the parents also. That's how we mold it, you know. And again, I would like to say there's a disclaimer here that one size doesn't fit all. So every parent should look at it differently. But just to give you all a gist, you know, the three H's that you all must follow is the head, the heart, and the hand. For the parents, the first thing is, you know, the hand. They use it for anything. They use this hand so negatively, and that's so wrong. Instead of this, if you really want to motivate a child, times have changed. You know, caning doesn't work anymore. It's only the carrot.
So, you know, Sagareeka, sharing just real life thing, which I have shared with a lot of people, and I do during my seminars, is that I was a very angry mom. So I have not used the hand so much, because you know, that time we were into not hitting kids, and I've been handed a lot. Mujhe bahut padi hai. But with my children, I was so strict with them. There came a time that they started lying to me because I was such an angry mom. So my motto was to bring them into a good human being. But I was so pressurizing on them, and I was so hard on them. Gradually, when I went through transformation and I started working on myself, I realized that it is good to inspire. And that's what I've been successful in doing. Is my son has just been certified as a life coach.
Oh, lovely.
He did a life coaching. He says, I want to impact lives. I want to transform lives. He's on to weight loss. He's wanting to, you know, do programs and become a speaker. And so it has completely changed. So I have inspired him from a gaming child and somebody who used to lie to me to somebody. That also a child who was given less importance than my daughter, because I, like I said, but consciously when I changed the parameter.
Right, your outlook, you changed your outlook
completely.
Towards him, exactly.
Yes.
And that is good that you realized it early. So this is what, you know, for every parent also, when I say the head, you know, that is very, you can use your brains to justify what you're doing with them. You need to think twice before speaking, think twice before doing any action with them, you know, and also whenever it is you, if you are emotionally stable, can you bring that stability at home?
True.
So it's very important for parents themselves to be very emotionally stable, to bring that. And if the children are emotionally stable, I tell you, then they can really reach greater heights. There is no insecurity. The insecurity is something that we build into them. They are not born insecure. But the parents being insecure, being emotionally unstable, brings that insecurity.
So imagine,
so that
the,
is something,
imagine,
you know,
the mothers not going out,
yes,
because kids have exams.
Exactly.
Taking
is,
a leave. You know, I understand ki they mean good to the child. But so much of importance given to those 10-15 days,
yeah, it's
completely
not it.
Changes
not,
the perception. So,
yes,
you know, the
yes.
pressure, the pressure.
Yes.
So even when you're doing projects or you're doing your entrepreneurial journey, you're doing something which is high end, you know, which has to have a performance, then the first thing is stress, anxiety, anger, frustration, screaming, yelling, you know.
Absolutely.
And that's
absolutely.
What children pick
absolutely.
Up from parents.
And the next edge after the head comes, you know, heart. That is conflict management. Yes, head is full of conflict, but then that conflict management, if your heart is a stable heart, if your heart is a pleasant heart, if your heart is a heart which is not enraged, I think can do wonders to the whole family, you know.
Right.
Not only to the whole family, to the whole society in which you live in, you know.
Understood.
You can share that love, and love can, and you can change people's perspective with love. With love. And these children, all they need is love from
True.
Us, you know. And if we can fulfill that want of theirs, that craving of theirs for love, I think then we have achieved whatever we want in this life. Once you give them love, then they will go out and they'll share the same love. They'll also learn to love, you
true,
know.
True.
And then once they learn to love, then the society is a very beautiful, the world will be a beautiful place, you know. But sadly, the jargon love has been taken in a very wrong way, in a very wrong direction. But I think we can, there's always, we educationists are always, and even people like you who are into women empowerment, into child empowerment, I think we all can work in tandem together.
Of course.
To teach them these lessons of love, you know, self-love.
So,
and love,
Sagareeka, earlier, you know, I used to go to my kids' school. Tanya Valecha is
the
principal to my children. And I used to go to the school and I used to look at her differently, and I used to be in the queue waiting to meet her, and there was always stress. What is it? Did my child do something wrong? Did it happen? Now I'm chilled out. So I've done a couple of workshops in the school. I met. So now that I have access to a lot of children and I meet them, small things makes them happy. Like you're saying,
right,
heart.
Right, exactly.
Small things.
Yes.
So Sagareeka, tell us the third edge.
Yeah, the third edge.
I think
is the head. Yeah.
You can look into our audience and share with them. Yes.
Yeah. The third edge is the hand, you know. I mean, as I said when we began, that the hand can be used very negatively, and that's what actually most of the parents we do. But this particular hand, let me tell you, parents, has a lot of power, immense power in it. This little hand, if you just touch it this way to the child, if you just touch it this way to the child, if you just touch it this way to the child, I mean, the connection, you know, we are always looking for correction. But this connection, once we make this connection with this hand, with our child, and then we make the correction, I tell you, that correction has a lot of meaning. Lot of meaning. It's a very simple procedure that you all can follow. Every day in the morning, just have that physical touch with your child and bless your child. However it is, just say, God bless you, my child. Have a nice day. And this touch, and with good words with the child, I tell you, your whole relationship will change. Your whole
relationship.
And it's a tried and tested method.
So, Sagareeka, I'm going to reinforce this.
Yes.
That I have a teenage daughter. And she said, Mom, my friends say your mom is the only one who says go out, have party, you know, go do. And this touch, you know, holding her, hugging her, and getting it in return. You know, even the parents need it. Your child coming into your arms cannot be more powerful than
absolutely,
anything.
Absolutely.
So this has been my journey with my teenage daughter. And a lot of things. See, there are many years for me to see her into the teenage. So there will be ups and downs. There are mood swings. But this touch has really worked very powerfully for me.
Exactly.
And all we need is we hold hands, we hug, and we share our ideas in close proximity. It's not WhatsApp or something. We have a family bonding time, which is not going out on vacations or spending or eating, but just a conversation.
Yes, I'll tell you, you know, I've worked with juvenile delinquents. A lot of juvenile delinquents, I teach them maybe spoken English, little small things that I work with them, all of these who are in the jails, you know. So I go there maybe once a year or twice a year as and when I'm called there. And I have realized when I work with those children, they need nothing else. They've just deviated from their normal lives of being a child is because they didn't get the love that they wanted, that they
so,
needed.
So
you know?
What you're saying, no, I've been with Don Bosco boys for a year. I used to go there and all I worked on them was power beliefs. What do you believe you are? What are your dreams? So there was a young boy who had one eye was ruptured or something, and he had a very strange smile, and he was black and very dark and very tiny skinny guy, and he stands up and says, "Mujhe actor banna hai." The moment he said that, the other 30-40 children just broke out into laughter, right. And they made so much fun of him, and that is the time that I made a shift. I made them believe that this is his dream. Who has the right? Who has given you the right to steal it?
Exactly.
Yeah?
Or to
I told that child ki, that is everything is possible, because we've seen actors across the globe, irrespective of the color, size, shape, and that really built something in him. So children are seeing the other people ridicule or just have a frame, you know, ki, you know, an actor is like this and model is like this and a doctor is like this.
Right.
So one guy stood up from and says, "Ma'am, you showed that he can be an actor. So I want to be an IAS officer. I have no means." I said, "Why can't you? Tell me the reasons why you can't." So he said, this problem. So we just sat down and gave that human touch. And I said,
right,
it is possible.
Right,
it is not a miracle which will happen.
Right.
So I think a lot of crime, violence,
will be taken care of,
yes.
You know, and I think good mentoring, having a humane approach, you know, that is what is more important. That is what is more important as parents also, as individuals also, as people walking. If we walk on the streets, you know, you see somebody in distress, just even if you give them a smile, you can change that person's day.
True.
You can just change that person's day. So I think these are the things as human beings we must follow, and of course as parents, very important.
So
very important.
That you've shared all your knowledge and your real life experiences, and we have risen, tell us something more about what's your hobbies. You said you need to have a one more edge.
Oh yes.
So share your hobbies and share your dreams with me.
Yes. I did say that the other edge from the head, hand and heart that you would want to add is hobbies. Everyone must have a hobby, because life becomes very stressful, especially in current times, you know. It's too demanding. Children are demanding, work is demanding, home is demanding, the work-life balance is, I mean, you're unable to maintain the balance.
Oh my God.
You know, it's too much,
yeah.
It's too much. But I think all of these things can be taken care of if you have a hobby. And what should be your hobby? Your hobby should be one that can generate you money. The hobby also should be one that can keep you happy. And the hobby also should be one that can connect you to people.
So I'll share one experience.
Yeah.
Last 2 weeks I took off from my work and I gave time to my kids. I'm on a seminar out, so I'm not there on weekends. So now my kids were like busy and my written exams are going on this end. And as a mother, I know comfort food is something lovely. So saving money rather than making money.
Right.
I just went and found some best recipes that were easy. Different types of pastas and different types of food and pindi chow. So what I have done is now with my kids, I share a YouTube video which they love.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so we are connected and we plan this recipe. So my daughter will order the ingredients, my son will make sure that things are ready, and then I will do the raw material. And then from the morning they are anticipating, aaj pasta milega, this one. Today I'm going to have this, today I'm going to have that.
Right.
So that has created such a warm bond between us.
And that's the emotional connect that you're creating.
And I'm a foodie myself. So this is like a win-win hobby for all of us, you know. Cooking together, planning together. It also teaches my children that, you know, you need to plan this. This thing costs so much.
Right.
So it's a very effortless, small things that you can do to bond. So, and what you are saying, hobby, I have been dying to paint from a very long time.
So now you better get started. Let me tell you, if you paint, you will see that you will de-stress yourself and you will move far and you will be able to do much more things, because then in the mind, all your frustration is gone.
And you know, guess what I paint? When I was going through, like I have gone through 11 litigation cases and more. I mean, more ups and downs in life. But you know what I did? I joined a painting class and I used to sit and paint those hair of those Shih Tzu dog, you know, loads and loads of colors and all. And I used to forget hours and hours. I used to keep painting and that's a therapy, you know. So a lot of your hobbies can help you come out of situations. A lot of hobbies can be used for bonding. And now that she has reinforced her edge, I'm going to really keep out and doing that. I've been doing that. But I really believe that Sagareeka has got such a huge, vast experience. What's your dream, Sagareeka?
My dream, actually, I have achieved almost all of my dreams. My dream was to complete my PhD, which I completed last year. Now, I'm only dreaming, you know, of traveling. I'm very fond of traveling.
So,
and
we can backpack together, because
my
dream.
And I've traveled
well.
A lot. There are only just very few destinations left, which I think in this lifetime I'll cover before you.
So, I've been to a lot of places, but I've been as a traveler. So, my new vision and mission is, and my dream is that I need to go to each and every country and impact 1,000 people or a couple
very
of thousand
good, so
people.
Very good. So, I join you in that.
Yes.
Yeah, I share the same emotions as you, that even I would want to connect.
Yes.
Now, till now, traveling was just for myself.
Looking at
but now,
art
yes,
museums
yes,
and all
yes,
that.
Yes.
So, I want to make meaningful conversations and maybe we can go do a travel show together.
Yes, yes. Why not? Why not? We should. We
Super.
Should. Let's start for somewhere as close as Vasai in Mumbai maybe.
True.
You know? And just go to Vasai and
yeah,
speak,
yeah.
start speaking
anywhere,
to people
anywhere.
In the vegetable market. We can just
Super.
Do that. Yes.
Lovely.
Yes, yes, yes.
So, guys, some amazing ideas from some amazing women. And yes, I love myself and I love the way she's shared. And common goals, common dreams, common vision and mission. A lot of us want to do a lot of things. But how many of us take the step towards doing it? That's where your hand comes, you know, action, taking
action.
Action.
Yes.
So take action and share this video with parents. And you won't believe what Sagareeka has achieved. You can see this, you know, a range of awards and rewards. So much more to go. Thank you, Sagareeka.
Thank you so much, Gemini. Wonderful talking to you.
Same here.
Yeah? And wonderful audience who are going to watch this particular video. Love you all. Be good. Be kind.
That's like a true principle. Thank you so much, Sagareeka. Yeah.